Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture on the subject Engineering Thermodynamics. We are discussing the module 6, Steam Power Cycle or Vapor Power Cycle, and this is lecture number 606. And we recap from the previous lecture. In the previous lecture 605, we discussed the regenerative Rankine cycle with one feed water heater and regenerative Rankine cycle with two feed water heater, and we derived various performance parameter, work done by the turbine, work input to the pump, heat supply and the efficiency of the regenerative Rankine cycle. And in this lecture, we are going to solve problems on the regenerative Rankine cycle, and the learning outcome for this lecture. At the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problems in the regenerative Rankine cycle. So, we take example from the anionized question paper, November 2012, example number 13. The steam enters the turbine at 3 megapascal and 400 degree Celsius, and it is condensed at 10 kilopascal. Some quantity of the steam leaves the turbine at 0.6 megapascal and enters the feed water heater. Compute the fraction of steam extracted per kg of the steam and the cycle thermal efficiency. And the given data, so P1 equal to P7 equal to 30 bar, T1 equal to 400 degree Celsius, P2 equal to P5 equal to P6 equal to 6 bar, that the pressure in the feed water heater is 6 bar. And the outlet pressure, condenser pressure is P3 equal to P4 equal to 0.1 bar. And from the steam table, at the entry condition, from the steam table, P1 equal to 30 bar and T1 equal to 400 degree Celsius. It is superheated steam at the entry of the turbine. So, H1 equal to 3232.5 kilojoules per kilogram, and S1 entropy equal to 6.925 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And for the feed water heater, pressure of the feed water heater is 6 bar. At the 6 bar, VF2 equal to 0.001101 meter cube per kilogram. HF2 equal to 670.4 kilojoules per kilogram. HG2 equal to 2755.5 kilojoules per kilogram. SG2 equal to 6.758 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And TS2 equal to 158.8 degree Celsius or 431.8 Kelvin. And this is the temperature entropy diagram. So, one is the superheated steam and two is the condition of the feed water heater, pressure of the feed water heater, and here it is condenser. So, from the steam table, at P3 equal to P4 equal to 0.1 bar, so at the condenser condition, VF3 equal to 0.00101 meter cube per kilogram, HF3 equal to 191.8 kilojoules per kilogram, HFG3 equal to 2392.9 kilojoules per kilogram, SF3 equal to 0.649 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, and SFG3 equal to 7.502 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. So, we are given the pressure, all the three pressure are given. So, the feed water heater pressure is 0.6 megapascal, entry pressure is 33 megapascal, and condenser pressure is 0.10 kilopascal. So, we have taken properties from the steam table. Expansion between 1 and 2 in the turbine, S1 equal to S2, S1 equal to SG2 plus Cp into logarithmic of T2 by TS2. That is, we assume at the 0.2, it is superheated steam. So, substituting the value, 6.925 equal to 6.758 plus 2.2 into logarithmic of T2 by 431.8. and T2 equal to 465.8 Kelvin. So, the temperature here, it is 465.8 Kelvin. Now, the enthalpy H2 equal to HG2 plus Cp into T2 minus TA2. So, it is superheated steam. So, enthalpy of the superheated steam equal to HG2 plus Cp into T2 minus TS2. So, substituting values 2755.5 plus 2.2 into 465.8 minus 431.8 equal to 2830.3 kilojoules per kilogram, and H6, so here H6 equal to the stagnation, saturation enthalpy of the water, enthalpy of water at the pressure P2, which is HF2, which is 670.4 kilojoules per kilogram. So here H of 6 equal to H of 2, enthalpy of water. Now for the expansion between 2 and 3, so 2 and 3 it is superheated steam and here it is assumed as wet steam. So S1 equal to S3 equal to SF3 plus X3 into SFG3, 6.925 equal to 0.649 plus X3 into 7.502, solving this equation X3 equal to 0.83. So now H3 equal to H3 plus X3 into HFG3. So substituting enthalpy H3 equal to 191.8 plus 0.83 into 2392.9 equal to 2177.9 kilojoules per kilogram. H4 equal to HF3. So H4 enthalpy here, saturated liquid. So H4 equal to HF3 equal to 191.8 kilojoules per kilogram. Now the pump work. For the pump 1, WP, pump 1 equal to H5 minus H4 equal to VF4 into P5 minus P4. So the H5 minus H4 equal to 0.00101 into 6 minus 0.1 into 100. So H5 minus H4 equal to 0.6 kilojoules per kilogram. So H5 equal to 191.8 plus 0.6 equal to 192.4. And similarly, enthalpy rise for the pump 2, H7 minus H6 equal to VF6 into P7 minus P6. So H7 minus H6 equal to 0.001101. Into 30 minus 6 into 100, that is equal to H7 minus H6 equal to 2.64 kilojoules per kilogram. So H7 equal to 670.4 plus 2.64 equal to 673.04 kilojoules per kilogram. So now we have calculated all the enthalpy. So look at here. So H1 and H2, H6, H3, H4, H5 and then H7. Everything we calculated. Now we use the energy balance for the feed water heater. M into H2, 1 minus M into H5 equal to H6. So H6 equal to M into H2 plus 1 minus M into H5. Substituting 670.4 equal to M into 2830.3 plus 1 minus M into 192.4. Solving this equation. M equal to 0.18 kilograms per second. Now we calculate the turbine work. Turbine work equal to H1 minus H2 plus 1 minus M into H2 minus H3. Substitute the values 3232.5 minus 2830.2 plus 1 minus 0.18 into 2830.3 minus 2177.9 equal to 937.1 kilojoules per kilogram. Pump work equal to 1 minus M into H5 minus H4 plus H7 minus H6. So 1 minus 0.8 into 0.6 plus 2.64 equal to 3.1 kilojoules per kilogram. And heat separate QS equal to H1 minus H7. So 3232.5 minus 673.04 equal to 2559.46 kilojoules per kilogram. So thermal efficiency equal to eta equal to WT minus WP. Divided by amount of heat supplied equal to 937.1 minus 3.1 divided by 2559.46, which is equal to 0.3649 or 36.49%. So the answer to the problem, the fraction of steam extracted M equal to 0.18 kilograms per second and the thermal efficiency of the cycle equal to 36.49%. We take the next example, example number 14 from the Anna University question paper November 2016. A steam power plant operates on an ideal regenerative Rankine cycle. The steam enters the turbine at 6 MPa and 450 degrees Celsius, is condensed in the condenser at 20 kPa. The steam is extracted from the turbine at 0.4 MPa to heat the feed water in an open feed water heater. water level in the feed water heater are saturated. Water leaves the feed water heater as saturated liquid. So the cycle in the TS plane and determine net to work output per kg of the steam, thermal efficiency of the cycle. So this is the temperature entropy diagram for the cycle, and this is what the given data. So given data, P1 equal to P7 equal to 60 bar, T1 equal to 450 degree Celsius, P2 equal to P5 equal to P6 equal to 4 bar, and P3 equal to P4 equal to 0.2 bar. So the pressure given here are noted. Now from the steam table, at the P1 equal to 60 bar and T1 equal to 450 degree Celsius, from the superheated steam table, H1 equal to 3301.15 kilojoules per kilogram, entropy S1 equal to 6.714 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And from the steam table, P2 equal to 4 bar for feed water heater, VF2 equal to 0.001084 meter cube per kilogram, HF2 equal to 604.7 kilojoules per kilogram, HFG2 equal to 2132.9 kilojoules per kilogram, and SF2 equal to 1.776 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, and SFG2 equal to 5.118 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And for the condenser pressure, P3 equal to P4 equal to 0.2 bar, VF3 equal to 0.001017 meter cube per kilogram, HF3 equal to 251.5 kilojoules per kilogram, and HFG2 equal to 2358.4 kilojoules per kilogram, SF3 equal to 0.832 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, and SG3 equal to 7.077 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. So from the steam table, the properties are taken. Now we go to the calculation. Expansion between 1 and 2 in the turbine, S1 equal to S2, and SF2, we take S2, we assume the condition 2 is wet steam. So, S2 equal to SF2 plus X2 into SFG2. So, 6.714 equal to 1.776 plus X2 into 5.118. So, X2 equal to 0.96. Then, H2, enthalpy of the steam, H2 equal to HF2 plus X2 into HFG2. So, H2 equal to 604.7 plus 0.96 into 2132.9. So, using the calculator, H2 equal to 2652.3 kilojoules per kilogram. And H6, so refer to the diagram. So H6 equal to HF6, which is equal to HF2. So the H6 equal to HF2 equal to 604.7 kilojoules per kilogram. And for the expansion between 2 and 3 in the turbine, S1 equal to S3 equal to SF3 plus X into SFG3. So 6.714 equal to 0.832 plus X3 into 7.077. So solving this equation will get X3 equal to 0.83. Then the enthalpy of the steam, H3 equal to HF3 plus X3 into HFG3. So H3 equal to 251.5 plus 0.83 into 2358.4. So using the calculator, H3 equal to 2208.9 kilojoules per kilogram. Then H4 equal to HF3, which is 251.5 kilojoules per kilogram. Then enthalpy rise in the pump 1, H5 minus H4 equal to VF4 into P5 minus P4, H5 minus H4 equal to 0.001017 into 4 minus 0.2 into 100, so it is 0.4 kilojoules per kilogram, and H5 equal to 251.5 plus 0.4 equal to 251.9 kilojoules per kilogram. For the pump 2, enthalpy rise in the pump 2, H7 minus H6 equal to VF6 into P7 minus P6. So H7 minus H6 equal to 0.001084 into 60 minus 4 into 100, which is 6 kilojoules per kilogram. So H7 equal to 604.7 plus 6 equal to 610.7. Now we have calculated all the enthalpy, H1 to H7, H1, H2, H3, H4, H5, H6 and H7. Now we use the energy balance for the feed water heater. So to calculate the mass of the bleeding steam, so H6 equal to M into H2 plus 1 minus M into H5. So the 604.7 equal to M into 2652.3 plus 1 minus M into 251.9. So solving this equation, m equal to 0.14 kilograms per second. Then the turbine work. So turbine work equal to H1 minus H2 plus 1 minus m into H2 minus H3. So substituting the values, H1 equal to 3301.5, H2 equal to 2652.2, 1 minus m equal to 0.1 minus 0.14, and H2 equal to 2652.3 minus 2208.9 equal to 1030.1 kilojoules per kilogram, and the pump work equal to 1 minus m into H5 minus H4 plus H7 minus H6. So 1 minus 0.014 into 0.4 plus 6 equal to 6.34 kilojoules per kilogram. Net work output equal to WT minus WP is equal to 1030.1 minus 6.34 equal to 1023.76 kilojoules per kilogram. So heat supplied in the regenerative cycle, QS equal to H1 minus H7, which is 3301.5 minus 610.8 equal to 2690.35 kilojoules per kilogram. And the thermal efficiency of the cycle, eta equal to WT minus WP divided by heat supplied. So WT minus WP net work output equal to 1023.76 divided by 2690.35 equal to 0.38, which is 38%. So the answer to the problem, net work output is 1023.6 kilojoules per kilogram and the thermal efficiency equal to 38%. And we take example number 15. So this was asked in the three times, May 2019, November 2019 and May 2016. So in a steam power plant, the condition of the steam at the inlet to the steam turbine is 20 bar and 300 degrees Celsius, and the condenser pressure is 0.1 bar. Two feed water heaters operates at the optimum temperatures, determine the quantity of the steam at turbine exhaust, the quality of the steam at the turbine exhaust, net work per kg of the steam, cycle efficiency, steam rate. Neglect the pump work. So pump work is neglected. So this is the diagram, and P1 equal to 20 bar and T1 equal to 300 degrees Celsius. So it is superheated steam, but here we have reference temperatures, saturated steam, but it is superheated steam. P4 equal to 0.1 bar. Pump work is neglected. So H5 equal to H6, H7 equal to H8, and H9 equal to H10. So we take the properties from the steam table at P1 equal to 20 bar, T1 equal to 300 degrees Celsius for superheated steam, H1 equal to 3025 kilojoules per kilogram, S1 equal to 6.77 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, and the saturation temperature is 212.4 degrees Celsius. At steam table, P4 equal to 0.1 bar, TS4 equal to 45.83 degrees Celsius, HF4 equal to 191.8 kilojoules per kilogram, HFG4 equal to 2392.9 kilojoules per kilogram, SF4 equal to 0.649 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, and SFG4 equal to 7.502 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And the feed water heater operates at the optimum temperature. So the optimum temperature, TS1 minus TS4 divided by 3 equal to 212.4 minus 45.3 divided by 3 equal to 55.5 degree Celsius. The temperature difference is 55.5 degree Celsius. So the temperature of the feed water heater 1, so 212, that is saturation temperature here, 212 minus 55 equal to 157, we make it as 155 degree Celsius. Then feed water heater 2, T3 equal to T155 minus 55 equal to 100 degree Celsius. So the saturation temperature of the turbine entry is 212.4 degree Celsius. The temperature of the feed water heater 1 is 155 degree Celsius, and temperature of the feed water heater 2 is 100 degree Celsius. Now from the steam table, at T2 equal to 155 degree Celsius, HF2 equal to 653.8 kilojoules per kilogram, HFG2 equal to 2097.4 kilojoules per kilogram, SF2 equal to 1.892 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, and SFG2 equal to 4.899 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. So for the expansion between 1 and 2, S1 equal to S2, S1 already we have taken from the steam table, S1 equal to SF2 plus X2 into SFG2. So the 6.77 equal to 1.892 plus X2 into 4.899. So solving this equation, X2 equal to 0.99. So H2 equal to HF2 plus X2 into HFG2, 653.8 plus 0.99 into 2097.4 equal to 2730.2 kilojoules per kilogram. So enthalpy at the point 2 is 2730.2 kilojoules per kilogram. So from the steam table, at T3 equal to 100 degrees Celsius, HF3 equal to 419.1 kilojoules per kilogram, HFG3 equal to 2256.9 kilojoules per kilogram, SF3 equal to 1.307 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, SFG3 equal to 6.048 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. For expansion between 2 and 3, S1 equal to S3, S1 equal to S3, S1 equal to SF3 plus X3 into SFG3, so 6.77 equal to 1.307 into X3 into 6.048. So solving this equation, X3 equal to 0.9, then H3 equal to enthalpy of the steam, H3 equal to HF3 plus X3 into HFG3 equal to 419.1 plus 0.9 into 2256.9 equal to 2450.3 kilojoules per kilogram. So H3 equal to 2450.3 kilojoules per kilogram. For expansion between 3 and 4, S1 equal to S4. So S1 equal to SF4 plus X4 into SFG4. So 6.77 once again equal to 0.649 plus X4 into 7.502. So solving this equation, X4 equal to 0.81. Then the enthalpy H4 equal to HF4 plus X4 into HFG4, which is 191.8 plus 0.81 into 2392.9 equal to 2130 kilojoules per kilogram. Then enthalpy of the pump, so H5 equal to H6 equal to HF4, H7 equal to H8 equal to HF3 equal to 419.1, H10 equal to H9 equal to HF2 equal to 653.8 kilojoules per kilogram. Then the energy balance for the feed water heater 1, so H9 equal to 1 M1 into H2 plus 1 minus M1 into H8, so substituting 653.8 equal to M1 into 2730.2 plus 1 minus M1 into 419.1, and solving this equation, so we will get M1 equal to 0.1 kilograms per second. Then for the feed water heater 2, then energy balance for the feed water heater 2, 1 minus M1 into H7 equal to M2 into H3 plus 1 minus M1 minus M2 into H6. So substituting M1 equal to 0.1, 1 minus 0.1 into H7 419.1 equal to M2 into H3 plus 1 minus M1 is 0.1 minus M2 into 191.8, and solving this equation, we'll get M2 equal to 0.09 kilograms per second. So we have calculated M1 and M2 values. It is just energy balance. So don't worry about any. It is simple arithmetic calculation using the energy balance. Now the turbine work, WT equal to H1 minus H2 plus 1 minus M1 into H2 minus H3 plus 1 minus M1 minus M2 into H3 minus H4. Substituting the values, 3025 minus 2730.2 plus 1 minus 0.1 into 2730.2 minus 2450.3 plus 1 minus 0.1 minus 0.09 into 2450.3 minus 2130. So the answer is turbine work equal to 806.3 kilojoules per kilogram. And heat supplied QS equal to H1 minus H10. So 3025 minus 653.8 equal to 2371.2 kilojoules per kilogram. So the power output, so M into power output equal to M into WT minus WP. So WP equal to 0. So 1 into 806.3 equal to 806.3 kilojoules per kilogram. Then thermal efficiency is WT minus WP divided by heat supplied, which is 806.3 divided by 2371.2 equal to 0.34, which is 34%. So steam rate equal to, See, SR equal to 3600 divided by net work output, which is 3600 divided by 806.3 equal to 4.46 kilograms per kilowatt hour. So, the answer to the problem, the quality of the steam at the turbine exhaust is X4 equal to 0.81. Net to work per kg of the steam equal to 806.3 kilojoules per kilogram. Cycle efficiency equal to 34% and steam rate is 4.46 kilograms per kilowatt hour. And we take one more example from the November 2018 question paper. So, this is from the combined cycle. An adiabatic air compressor is to be powered by direct coupled adiabatic steam turbine that is also driving a generator. The steam enters the turbine at 12.5 megapascal and 500 degrees Celsius at a rate of 25 kilograms per second and exits at 10 kilopascal with a quality 0.92. The air enters the compressor at 98 kilopascal and 295 Kelvin at a rate of 10 kilograms per second and exit at 1 megapascal at and 620 Kelvin. Determine the net power delivered to the generator by the turbine. So, there is a steam turbine which is driving the compressor as well as a generator. Now, we have to calculate what is the amount of power delivered to the generator by the turbine. So, the given data P1 for the steam turbine, P1 equal to 12.5 megapascal, which is 125 bar, T1 equal to 500 degrees Celsius, P2 equal to 10 kilopascal, which is 0.1 bar, X2 equal to 0.92. So, from the steam table, P1 equal to 125 bar, T1 equal to 500 degrees Celsius, H1 equal to 3343.2 kilojoules per kilogram, and from steam table, P2 equal to 0.1 bar, HF2 equal to 191.8, HFG2 equal to 2392.9 kilojoules per kilogram. So, H2 equal to HF2 plus X2 into HFG2, which is equal to 191.8 plus 0.92 into 2392.9 equal to 2393.2 kilojoules per kilogram. Then turbine work output equal to H1 minus H2, which is 3343.1 minus 2393.2 equal to 950 kilojoules per kilogram. Power produced by the steam turbine, P equal to mass of the steam flow into turbine work. So, 25 into 950 equal to 23,750 kilowatts. Then given data for the air compressor, P1 equal to 98 kilopascal, T1 equal to 295 Kelvin, P2 equal to 1 megapascal, T2 equal to 650 Kelvin and mass equal to 10 kilograms per second. So, power required to drive the compressor, assuming adiabatic compression, P equal to MR into T1 minus T2 divided by gamma minus 1. So, 10 into 0.287 into 295 minus 620 divided by 1.4 minus 1 equal to minus of 2331.8. So, the negative sign implies that work is to be given to the compressor. Then the power available to drive the generator, which is 23750, the power produced by the steam turbine minus power consumed by the compressor minus of 2331.8. So, the remaining power is 21,418.2 kilowatts. So, the power available to drive the generator equal to 21,418.2 kilowatts. That is the answer to the problem. So, we stop here. So, these are all the reference book I used for preparing the slides. So, you can also refer to it for additional information and you can write to me to my mail ID. So, I will answer any queries or clarification. Thank you for watching and we will meet again.